walk across the meads now to the entrance to this memorial at Runnymede. And now she shakes hands with Mr. Geoffrey Jellicoe, the landscape architect responsible for the design of this memorial.
This acre of English soil is now bequeathed in perpetuity to the American people in memory of President John Fitzgerald Kennedy, who in death my people still mourn and whom in life they loved and admired.
It's an extremely moving affair. That works, that memorial. It's a very, very interesting and beautiful thing in every way. He put a tremendous effort into it. The idea that you walked up through the wood, and the path through the wood was of cobbles. All the stones were actually symbols of people. Not only were you walking on a sort of pilgrim's track, but the stones symbolized the people who would walk on that.
It didn't come until I'd started designing it, that what I was groping for was a parallel in landscape of the Pilgrim's Progress. You approach it through the wicket gate and through the wild woods of life. That is life. You then get to the catafalque at the top, which is the body carried on the symbolic forms of people. And then the future, which is Kennedy's concept of law and order reached by a form of Jacob ladder in stones. Very simple. It is only about a few days afterwards that you realize maybe that you've had a greater experience that is just visible to the eye. It's my subconscious through the thing to your visitor's subconscious. And this, I think, is the basis of all works of art, of all painting and so forth. I think the artist doesn't know it. I intellectualize it now, but the artist doesn't know that when he's doing his work, it pours out of him. And it's automatically there. If he's a great artist, it's automatically there in his work. So that you get the visible and the invisible all in one picture.